appearance from someone representing NYCLASS.
Good morning. I'm Martin Connor, and I'm an attorney representing NYCLASS. I'll be very brief. I just wanted to thank the staff of the board, the professionals, and for taking into account a situation that we're confronted with for the first time since the law has been regarding independent expenditures. And what I want to do is urge the board and the staff to, if you haven't already, include in your legislative program and push the city council to address a gap in the law. For many years, the charter provided that in the case of candidates where they retain a consultant who becomes their agent, for example, for compliance with CFP rules and the law, the board, the rules and the charter give the board jurisdiction to penalize the agent and in effect shift some of the penalty from the candidate to the agent, which is only fair. People who pay money to a consultant who says, I can handle all your compliance problems, and then doesn't do it. And the first case, I think, was the Fata case many years ago. The filings weren't made, but they were made. And the campaign was fined $500, and the bulk of the penalties was assessed on the agent. What happened here is the Charter Revision Commission, the last one, I guess, under Mayor Bloomberg, in their haste to put something on the ballot, put an amendment on dealing with independent expenditures, but they left out liability for agents. So I now represent a client that had a contract and paid money to a consulting firm that was accepted and wanted that they would comply with all laws and they would handle all campaign finance board compliance. And we're here because, in the opinion of the staff, and we have no basis to quarrel with that, they didn't do that job. But my client has to pay the fine, the agent gets off. At least the agent gets off. There's still a contract. The agent, or was a contract. The agent gets off vis-a-vis the statute. And so I would urge you to get the city council to address this gap, both because in the interest of justice, fairness, and deterrence in the future. Thank you very much.
Mr. Connor, I appreciate that, but am I correct, though, that the NYCLASS was aware that the advance group represented these two council candidates?
The president of NYCLASS was not aware. The executive director, who was a young organizer, pointed it out to them, and they said...
Her affidavit said she was aware. They told her.
Right, and they said, don't worry, we're taking care of that. And then they presented her with a bill from another company, so she had no basis to doubt them. They actually took care of it appropriately. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Connor. Is there a motion to go into executive session to discuss pending litigation and other matters?
So moved.
Before the board today is a recommended penalty for New Yorkers for Clean, Livable, and Safe Streets Incorporated, an independent spender in the 2013 election. For independent spending and supporting the candidacy of Lori Cumbo and Mark Levine for city council districts 35 and 7, respectively. For $7,618 for cooperating in expenditures reported to be independent for the Cumbo campaign, $8,436 for cooperating in expenditures reported to be independent for the Levine campaign, $5,000 for material misrepresentation in the Cumbo campaign, and $5,000 for material misrepresentation for the Levine campaign, for a total recommended penalties of $26,054.
Before we vote, I just think we want to make a few things clear. Well, these are very serious and severe penalties. They are not the maximum penalties, but they are very serious and severe because they are very serious violations by NYCLASS. I think that the board feels very strongly if you're going to become an independent spender from the perspective of the campaign finance board, you cannot outsource responsibility for compliance with the law. that is the responsibility of the independent spender, and that responsibility was not met here. And the reason for this not being the maximum penalty is because they have been cooperative with the board, and they are going to cooperate with the board as we continue proceedings involving the advance group in connection with potential penalties for their service as agents of the campaigns.
I move to accept the penalties as enunciated by Executive Director Lopez.
Second.
Aye.
Aye.